Good fine afternoon, YouTube. So at the moment I'm working on Homegirl's wand, and while I do so, I've conjured a lovely thunderstorm with my own wand. You can hear the rain pitter-pattering off the windows. Give me thunder for the awesome power of magic. Yes. Hanging out with Rastaman over here. And even he said, dude, I'd buy that wand if it was for sale. And he's real big into Rastafarian, so that's always good to get a third opinion. And the fourth opinion... Yo, the fourth opinion's my opinion. My opinion says that wand looked good. Damn, that fucking thunder was loud. Ah, I do love the smell of rain waffling through my apartment. That is just simply magnificent, you two. I was gonna go and collect sticks after a bit, but looks like now is definitely not the time. Let the thunderstorm run its course. While the thunderstorm runs its course, the wand I made for a friend of mine is drying, and hopefully she likes it. Although without the thunderstorm, she might. No telling. I'll keep you posted, though. I got it off the vice clamp that handles done drying to a point where I could have, where I could easily put podge on it. Oh. The thunderstorm, it speaks to me, you two. Right now I have the handle dangling over the edge, but I got my dark green spray paint and my black spray paint cans holding the wand up to dry. The wand part itself is dry enough that it won't come off anywhere. So I'll have to give it a couple hours before the handle's done drying. I should be able to give it to Homegirl tomorrow, hopefully. I'm gonna collect a bunch of wood for wands before I do that. Give it some extra time to dry now. I seem to have accidentally conjured a thunderstorm while producing a fine wand. It's quite understandable that the smell of tobacco and rain waffling through my apartment is simply... Oh, it's magnificent. Homeboy Alex and Homeboy Marshall came over earlier for a couple of brews. They brought over some beer. They're like, you want to drink? And I'm like, I'm down. Had a couple beers, you know. They left after a bit. And even they were saying, like, dude, that's a cool looking wand. Then my buddy Jeremy comes over and he's like, dude, that's a cool looking wand. So if I'm getting like three different opinions, not just mine, but also the people saying, yeah, that shit look good, then that's a good sign for me that you know, the feeling I get when I hold my wand, it's the feeling a lot of people get when they receive theirs. Batch number 3 has also been shipped out, so naturally I'm building a custom-made wand for a homie, and batch number 3 being shipped out. It's bound to rain a little bit.
Dude, it always starts raining whenever you start making your wands.
I know, right?
It always does.
And here comes the sun. Look at that.
Do-do-do-do.
That's what I was just thinking.
Here comes the sun.
Here comes the rain. Do-do-do-do. I shall show you what the wand looks like when it is done drying. Right now it is in a proper spot to dry. That thunderstorm we had has just passed us by momentarily. And now it is warm once again. Earlier, I had a bit of a fit with the paint. I was worried about it not looking good on the handle. I put too much red on the wand, and it dripped. Some of it dripped onto the handle a little bit. But when I got done drying, I think I was overthinking it just a bit. And the end result, it looked pretty good. The handle's still podging, but the wand part is at least dry. I think the hard work and dedication you put into each wand pays off, you too. So sipping on some Old English while I dried the wand. And now it's at a point where I can sit to the side and dry. It's basically done, just gotta wait for it to dry. It's on the very last step, and that feeling you get when the wand's just about done. Not compared to the feeling you get when people are receiving it. I'll catch you cool cobras on the flip side.